jerk. Seafood and vegan fest. And I'm telling y'all, it's going down. What you say, Cinnamon Snyder?
We got this. We got this. Who are we?
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Talking about. What you say, Cat Eye?
We got this.
We got it. We got it. Look, check this out. We do more fests. We do more shows. We do more live appearances than anybody in Chicago. And I'm talking about this going down right here. We killed it yesterday with Black Ice and the Legends of Chicago Hip Hop. We killing it this afternoon with Poet, and it's going down. And it's going down. We got 5 minutes before we get on stage. We got 5 minutes before we get on stage. I need y'all to get y'all mind right. Get out there and give these people a show. It's packed out there. We're going to make sure that everybody goes home knowing who People of Extraordinary Talent is. Who are we?
Poet!
Who are we?
Poet!
That's what I'm talking about. Clap it up, y'all. Y'all ready? Y'all ready? Are y'all ready?
We ready.
Are y'all ready?
We ready.
All right. All right. Slow down. Slow down.
Again, 1-2, 1-2, the extraordinary, most talented, yes sir, oh my gosh, Chicago, how y'all doing, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, Chicago, how y'all doing on this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Sunday, Poet family, make some noise, let's clap it up, yes, yes, y'all, we are the Poet Organization, we are an artist activist movement. We feed the hungry, we clothe the poor, we mentor in schools, we visit juvenile detention centers and prisons. Ladies and gentlemen, we use our art for activism work. We're going to call a young lady to the stage right now who goes by the name of Cat Eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, please give it up for my sister. Come on.
Good afternoon. My first piece is called The Third Eye. Your third eye is closed and it needs to be exposed to some divine light. You have a divine right to be able to see things mentally. We were all meant to be free. This, some of us won't see. I can't say don't see, because how could you miss it? We've all unwillingly been enlisted to work the rest of our lives for pieces of a dream, and it seems that some of us are happy with our few little fragments. Paying each day to live and breathe while the powers that be call it taxes, when the fact is, you come into this world as property and promptly tagged with a 9-digit identification so that in any situation, you can be found. It's not for your social security, because the police and government could care less about what happens to you and me. We need to find the connection. Do you know what you're capable of? Or have you settled for what you are aware of, which is nothing? Many of us are aware of nothing because we sit back and say nothing, act like we see nothing, act like we hear nothing. Soon, those three monkeys will kill us. This infection of ignorance on black minds is outstanding, and no one is demanding change. I find it strange that we refuse to remember the shackles and chains of slavery. In us no more is bravery like that of our brothers and sisters of the civil rights movement. We need improvement because we forgot what it meant to have unity. Beneath me are people who profess that we are free, sit back and watch TV 24 hours a day, people who I can honestly say don't contribute to their people in our plight or the betterment of their life. Go to church every Sunday with the pastor standing in the pulpit selling dreams because it seems that it's a good way to make a living. Yet it's given nothing to his community, which is soon to be demolished because the government's feeling frobish and jumped on the opportunity to drive you out of your house. And after service, you're standing next door at the liquor store with some wine. You need to find the connection. The question is whether you're using your mind right or is your hindsight a little blurred? Don't get deterred and stuck in religion. That's something you've been given to keep you in check. You're not doing anything that they didn't expect. It's like a game of chance or a sting, because every breath you take, every move you make, they'll be watching you. We need to practice discretion of our insurrection. We must be like a quiet storm to form the proper alliance, because compliance to their way of living is giving nothing to you. Your mind, your spirit has a limit to bestiality and wickedness. Are you feeling this? Instead of trying to have something, try to overstand something. Then you'll get what's coming. The power connection. The dissection of our unity took our community from pyramids to projects. Inch by inch, we made a profit of Willie Lynch. Getting back on top won't be a cinch. We need to revitalize, organize, open our third eyes so the revolution can begin. Our greatest sin is giving up, but I strive. I strive, do you? We don't need no more trouble, just our right and our fight. Will you? Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Cat Eyes one more time. We're about to introduce a young lady who's 17 years old. She's an opera classical singer. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you and bring to you A Symphony. We talked yesterday about the violence in our community, and we talked about the amount of young people that's been dying in our community. But there's a hidden hand behind these illegal guns coming into our community. There's a hidden hand behind these drugs that's coming right into our community. You don't find them in Beverly. You don't find them on the north side. You find them on the south side of Chicago and the west side of Chicago. And like any disease, sometimes they just worried about keeping it isolated where it is so it won't affect nothing else. Strange fruit with blood at the root.
And the twisted mouth, center magnolias, sweet and fresh.
I came here so you could talk to me.
And the sudden snow.
As a matter of fact, close your eyes, let our souls connect, and just take a spiritual walk with me, because we gotta ask ourselves some questions. These problems need solutions, so break out your pen and pad and take notes, because today, Black ISIS offer lessons. Tell me, why is it that freedom ain't free? And why is it that although our eyes are wide open, there's some things that we still can't see? See, y'all, this war is spiritual. It says words are spirits, I'm coming lyrical. It says ignorance is a killer, that cereal, this material was a blessing. No, matter of fact, it's a miracle. Tell me, why is it that most of our lives we just labor, sweat, and toil? And when our brothers out there killing brothers over dope, Bush killed people over oil. And we got governments killing people over soil. Tell me, why is it that tobacco companies are just not now telling you that in that stick, it was cancer, emphysema, and asthma. Maybe because it was death that they were selling you. And in Africa, I'm confused because the blood that they used and transfused had AIDS in it. And I want to go to church and pray my sins away, but the same ones trying to dip me in water, they need to bathe in it. And although as a young man, I broke a lot of rules, but I kept my two sons in the public because it's just too much sex education in Catholic school. Ain't that something, how you can molest little boys and take away their innocence and it's not even viewed as a crime? Because the only punishment they got was to step down from the priesthood when you know you should be serving jail time. The double standard of this nation confounds me. Now, that, if that had been me in Florida killing a white teen in a hoodie, your boy would have been like Blagojevich locked up in the county. And that incident that happened on 9/11 was more than a coincidence. Remember, it was this nation that separated God from state. Now these politicians want to pray. They ain't nothing but just a bunch of hypocrites. Why is it that 6 months before 9/11, the U.S. planned a war in Afghanistan? And it was so ironic that the same day the planes hit, they're in Afghanistan bombing the Taliban. Although no one had claimed responsibility but Black ICE, I sense a conspiracy. But check it out. American flight schools they trained at, American planes they used, and 19 men just so happened to get through airport security. Y'all smell that? I smell a rat. And out of the billions that were lost and out of the billions that were spent, we still ain't got our 40 acres in the view yet. See, with every good drama, you need a good guy and a villain. Oh, excuse me, my bad. Let me pick that up. Is that your beans that I'm spilling, the government? Do you know that standing right here, right now, I can be killed for what I'm saying, but I was born in the world to die. And that's the reason why I sat down and wrote this masterpiece and came up with the title called Why. And how can you justify killing an unarmed Black man who told you more than 11 times that he couldn't breathe, or a man with his hands up and no guns? And since we paying some of these police officers with our tax dollars, seems like we just paying some of these cops just to kill our son. And who would have thought that on a Wednesday night Bible class that the person sitting next to you could hurt you? But in South Carolina, this white supremacist killed 9 Black people. I guess it's safe to say that the devil goes to church too. And I know what y'all said. Black ICE, this is the Jerk Seafood and Vegan Fest. And what you're saying is a little bit too deep, and I truly understand. But when they start killing our Black sisters in police stations, it's time for us to stand up and say something. Hashtag Sandra Bland. In my conclusion, let me tell y'all a story. See, one day Truth and a Lyric swimming together. Y'all didn't hear me. I said, one day Truth and a Lyric swimming together. And when Lyric saw Truth in the water naked, Lyric put on Truth clothing and said, bye. And now y'all know what we got? What we got is a naked Truth, and he's trying to catch up with the well-dressed Lyric. But I want to thank y'all for listening to the Poet Organization. And there's only one thing left for me to say. Brothers and sisters, it's not a shame to be ignorant. It's just a damn shame to stay that way. Thank you.
It is a strange and
ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for our sister Cat Eyes. Make a nice poetry, y'all. Give it up. Give it up for our 17-year-old opera and classical singer, A Symphony. This is her mama, y'all, right here. Give it up for Cinnamon Slanker, DC. We got the enforcer. He just watched, make sure don't nobody rush the stage or nothing like that. Our legendary brother. Give it up for the legendary Big Mike, Eaglewood's very own. And I go by the name of King of Poetry, Black Ice. Thank y'all so much. Check us out on iampoet.org. We got CDs available. Hopefully you support our art. They only $10. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's right, Joe. I am poet. People of extraordinary talent. That's right. We're going to get back into some music. We got a lot of talent around. Everybody enjoy yourself. Support.